Hello students, hope all you are well. Today I will go through the chapter How the Earth Moves. Now we have to go through some specific points: introduction, rotation, revolution, seasons, solstices and equinoxes, and recapitulation. Now you see that our earth is a moving object. It is a celestial body. It takes around the sun, and it is having its own rotation on its axis. So we have to sure about the two movements of the earth, that is the rotation and the revolution. Now we have to go to the rotation. The way in which the earth moves is by spinning on its axis. One complete spin is called a rotation. The earth completes one rotation approximately every 24 hours. The earth rotates anti-clockwise on its axis. This is why the sun always rises in the east and sets in the west. Do you remember that the earth's axis is tilted slightly at an angle of 23.5 degrees to the horizontal surface? The tilt puts the earth's axis in line with the star named Polaris. Polaris is also known as North Star, since it is directly above the earth's axis. As it is directly above the earth's axis, it does not appear to move. However, the rest of the stars in the sky appear to move around the Polaris. It causes day and nights. The sun's rotation causes different parts of the earth to face it at different times. At any one point in time, only one hemisphere of the earth will get the sunlight. So, when it is night in one part of the earth, it is day half way across the earth. The circle that divides day from night on the globe is called the circle of illumination. You can have the circle of illumination in this picture. Now come to the revolution. We know that the earth moves around the sun as well. The path taken by the earth is not a perfect circle but an ellipse. The path, however, is fixed because of sun's gravitational force, keeps the earth in position. One complete movement along the elliptical path around the sun by the earth is called a revolution. So you know about the revolution. It completes 365.4 days, means to say that 365 days and 6 hours. What is the about the 6 hours? During this time, the earth is angled differently towards the sun at a different time. If we take the earth's year to be 365 days exactly, what happens to the 1/4 of the day or 6 hours? More than that, it takes to complete one revolution in each year. These are added up, and every 4th year has one extra day, which is 29th February. You know very well, it is called a leap year, and it includes 366 days. Now come to the seasons. The earth's revolution causes the northern and southern hemisphere to shift position. The earth is tilted on its axis. You know very well that tilted axis causes some places of the planet to further lean away from the sun and lean towards it. As a result, not all planets or the places on the earth in summer receives the sun rays the same way. This causes seasons. The hemisphere pointing towards the sun receives direct sunlight and more heat. It has summer. The hemisphere pointing away from it receives less heat, that is winter. Now come to the solstice and equinoxes. The seasonal length of the days and nights also varies because of the tilt. For instance, when it is summer in the northern hemisphere, the days get longer as one travels from the equator to the North Pole. At the North Pole, the sun does not set for many summer months. The reverse happens in the southern hemisphere. Here, the South Pole is in darkness for many months. So, the days on which the sun shines directly over either of the tropics are known as a solstice. The word solstice comes from the Latin word sol means sun and sistere means to stand still. On 21st June is the summer solstice and 21st December is the winter solstice. 21st June is the longest day and 21st December is the shortest day in the northern hemisphere. While twice a year the sun shines directly over the equator, the days on which this happens are known as equinoxes. When daytime and nighttime are equal, this happens around 21st March and 23rd September. After the equinox, the cycle reverses and it is summer in the southern hemisphere again and winter in the northern hemisphere again. Now we have to go for the recapitulation. Earth is the third planet in our solar system. This planet has its unique identity that has life existing environment. We know all the celestial bodies in the universe are in motion. Without motion, they can't be able to remain still. On to this, our Earth has two motions at all, rotation and a revolution. One of the major characteristics of the Earth is that it is tilted 23.5 degrees on its vertical axis. These two variants causes seasons, whereas rotation causes day and night on the Earth. This makes the perfect balance for the survival. Seasons too causes the climatic changes and other phenomena which are supporting characteristics of the life existence on the Earth. Thank you students for being with me. Thank you all.